The Haggis of Private McPhee by Robert William Service. Hae ye heard what my old mother's posted to me? It fair makes me homesick, says Private McPhee. And what did she send ye? Says Private McPhun, as he cocked his rifle and blazed at a hun. A haggis, a haggis, says Private McPhee. The brawest big haggis I ever did see. And think, it's the morn when fond memory turns to haggis and whisky, the birthday o' Burns. We maun find a dram, then we'll call in the rest of the lads and we'll hae a Burns nicht with the best. Be ready at sundown, snapped Sergeant McCall. I want you two men for the listening patrol. Then Private McPhee looked at Private McPhun. I'm thinking, my lad, we're confoundedly done. Then Private McPhun looked at Private McPhee. I'm thinking, old chap, it's halfway our spree. But, up spoke their crony, wee Willie McNair. Just leave your braw haggis for me to prepare. And as for the dram, if I search the camp roun', we maun hae a drappy to just hod it doon. Say run, lads, and think, though the nicht it be black, with a haggis that's waiting when you get back. My, but it was waesome in naebody's land, and the deed they were rotting on every hand, and the rockets like corpse candles haunted the sky, and the winds of destruction went shuddering by. There was skelping o' bullets and skirling o' shells, and bringing o' bombs and a thousand death knells. But, currying doon in a Jack Johnson hole, little fashed the twa men of the listening patrol. For sweeter than honey, and bricked as a gem, was the thought of the haggis that waited for them. Yet, alas, in our moments of sunniest cheer, calamities often maced cruelly near. And while the twa talked to their pudding divine, the Boche below them were howking a mine. And while the twa cracked to the feast they would hae, the fuse it was burning, and burning away. Then sudden a roar like the thunder of doom, a hell leap o' flame. Then the wheesht o' the tomb. Ha, joke, are ye hurtit? Says Private McPhun. Aye, Geordie, they've got me. I'm fearing I'm done. It's my leg. I'm just thinking it's half at the knee. You'd best gang and leave me, says Private McPhee. Oh, leave ye a winner, says Private McPhun, and leave ye a canna, for though I micht run, it's no forward gang, it's no muckle I'd see. I'm blinded, and that's what's the matter with me. Then Private McPhee sadly shaked his head. If we bide here for lang, we'll be biding for deed. And yet, Geordie lad, I could gang weel content if I'd tasted that haggis my old mother sent. That's droll, says McPhun. You've just speak it my mind. Oh, I ken it's a terrible thing to be blind, and yet it's no that that embitters my lot. It's missing that broad muckle haggis you've got. For a while they were silent, then up once again spoke Private McPhee, though he whistled with pain. And why should we miss it? Between you and me, we've legs for to run, and we've eyes for to see. You lend me your shanks, and I'll lend you my sicht, and we'll baith hae a kite fu' o' haggis the nicht. Oh, the sky it was dour-like and dreepin' away when Private McPhun gripped Private McPhee. Oh, the glory it was filin' and creashin' the grun when Private McPhee guided Private McPhun. Keep clear of them corpses, there may be no deed. Hold on, there's a big muckle crater ahead. Look out, there's a sap, we'll be haeing a coup. A store shell, for God's sake. Doon, lad, on your dope. Bear after your richt. Aye, you're doing just fine. Before the next finished on haggis we'll dine. There was death and destruction on every hand. There was havoc and horror on naebody's land. And the shells bickered doon wi' a crump and a glare, and the hameless wee bullets were dinging the air. Yet on they went staggering, currying doon, when the stutter and cluck o' a Maxim crept roun'. And the legs o' McPhun, they were sturdy and stout, and McPhee on his back kept a bonny lookout. On, on, my brave lad, we've no far to go. I can hear the braw swearing of Sergeant McCall. But strength has its limit, and Private McPhun, with a sob and a curse, fell his length on the ground. Then Private McPhee shouted down in his ear, "Just think of the haggis! I smell it from here. It's gushing with juice, it's embalming the air, it's steaming for us, and we're just about there." Then Private McPhun answers, "Damn it, old chap, for the sake of that haggis, I'll gang till I drop." And he gets on his feet with a heave and a strain, and onward he staggers in passion and pain. And the flare and the glare and the fury increase, till you'd think they'd just taken all hell on a lease. And on they go reeling in pitiful plight, and someone is shouting away on the right, and someone is running, and now they can hear a sound like a prayer and a sound like a cheer. And swift through the clash and the flash and the din, the lads of the Hielands are bringing them in. "They're both sorely wounded, but is it no droll how they rave about haggis?" says Sergeant McCall. "When hirpling along comes wee Willie McNair, and they all wonder why he was greeting sae sair. And he says, 'I just lifted it out of the pot, and there it lay steaming and savoury hot, when sudden I dooked at the fleece of your shell, and it dropped in the haggis and dinged it to hell.' I know, but the lads were fair taken aback. Then sudden the order was passed to attack, and up from the trenches like lions they leapt, and on through the night like a torrent they swept, on with their bayonets thirsting before, on to the foe with a rush and a roar, and wild to the welkin their battle cry rang, and down in the Bosch like tigers they sprang, and there wasna a man but had death in his ee, for he thought of the haggis, O Private McPhee.'"